You are watching William Patterson University Television.
Welcome back. My guest tonight is an alumni. That's why. Question mark of William Patterson University. He used to have my job as the program director of the award-winning Brave New Radio. He can now be heard overnight every weeknight on Z100. Please give it up for Nick Gomez.
Yeah.
How are you?
Great. How
are
you?
Good to see you. Long time no see. Literally.
Thank you so much for having me. I can't believe you brought back the Nicky No Shoes name.
Yeah, that was your original on-air name here?
Yeah. I used to go over to my neighbor's house always without wearing shoes. Mm-hmm. And so she coined the phrase Nicky No Shoes. And I was like, I should use it as a radio name and dropped it out of college.
Smart choice.
I dropped out of college.
Smart choice. Smart choice. It's been November since we've seen you last, right? How are you?
Oh, yeah. Actually, yeah.
Yeah. How are you? How's life?
Great. Same old, you know.
No, not really. It's a lot going on.
Is there?
Yeah. Well, you just moved.
That's
a personal thing. How's that going? Is there?
It's good. I'm living with my same roommate and another friend, so we added a person to the bunch.
Ooh, and they were roommates.
Move went great, except now there's like construction happening outside our apartment the whole time. I like can't sleep.
Isn't that what you moved away for? Didn't you tell me that? Didn't
literally
you say that was
moved.
The same reason you left?
Yeah, what we moved away from in Jersey City to a different area. Now they're ripping up the street, so.
That's good. You said you had an incident with your roommate's dog, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. Listen, I have a love-hate relationship with this dog. I've had dogs my entire life. Mm-hmm. And I love dogs, but I don't think this dog loves me. I was taking a shower one day. Mm-hmm. I left my bedroom door open. First mistake. Mm-hmm. I came out answering a text on my phone.
Right.
I smelled something.
Mm. I was like, I just took a shower. This
was it wasn't really a familiar smell. Just kind of caught me off guard. Mm-hmm. Answering a text. I look up and like direct in my eye line, on top of my bed, this dog took a massive dump. Mm. Just right on top of my sheets.
The dog's cute though. So is that the pass?
Yeah. He did it again.
Oh, this is a reoccurring thing.
I hope that we're done with it now, mm-hmm. but he did it a second time.
When you moved to the new place, he did it again?
No, it was right before we moved out of the old place, so maybe it was just kind of like a parting gift.
Yeah. Mm-hmm,
but yeah, same thing, door open, right out the shower and...
Yeah. Well, you moved, so congrats on that.
Thank you.
Also at the top of this year, first of all, congratulations. You're doing so much. It's been a big last year for you. You, at the top of this year, you celebrated 2 years at Z100, which is amazing.
I did. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it's been a wild year, mm-hmm. also a wild 2 years.
Yeah.
And also just a wild 24 years. Just a lot going on all the time.
You went full-time at Z100 it's been almost a year. That was last May.
Yep.
How's that been?
Fun. Draining. Because mm-hmm. I do overnight, so it's 2 a.m. to 6 a.m., Tuesday through Friday.
Right.
And that's, yeah, a lot.
So the sleep schedule is just non-existent.
Yeah, I just kind of sleep whenever. Mm-hmm. But it's the most fun job ever. I couldn't, when I was going to school here, if you told me that I was going to be working full time on Z100, New York's number one hit music station, I wouldn't have believed you. Because at that point, it was like, I was begging for an internship anywhere, especially there. And then I got that, and I was like, oh my God, this has to be me rising to my highest level of incompetence.
Yeah.
And then I got this job, and so they just kind of let me say things on Z100, and it's like...
I think you should bring back the Nicky No Shoes there.
Oh, no. I think that jersey's been retired. Yeah. You can see it up in the rafters somewhere.
I want to say thank you because you did a shout-out for us on Z100 for College Radio Day this past October, so thank you. Shouted Brave New Radio out. So you were the program director. You were two program directors before myself. Mm-hmm. You were nominated for Best College Program Director.
Something that you've shown me up on.
No worries. I know. No, I do want to say thank you. You can clap. It's fine. No. I want to say thank you for that because without your mentorship, I don't feel like I'd be in the position that I am as the best program director in the country. So I do thank you for that.
Oh, well, thank you for the nice words. Listen, college radio is a very important thing to me, mm-hmm. And I love seeing it be a very important thing to other people.
Right.
Because of the places that it can elevate us to.
Absolutely.
And the same thing goes for like TV here. Mm-hmm. You take this stuff seriously and really put like good work into it. And as all of the alumni that come from this building show, you can really end up in a great place. So it warms the cockles of my heart.
The who?
The cockles.
Cockles. Okay. Yeah. Gotcha.
Don't forget the last syllable, jeez.
Yeah. What you didn't mention to me and my mentorship as PD is that with this job comes like hate. I've been told lately that people not necessarily hate me. People are intimidated by me. People aren't like very fond of me. And you weren't. You were very interestingly perceived. I guess that's the word we're gonna go with when you were here.
Yeah. Well, I mean that comes with being a college student who thinks that you're like the hottest chip on the block. I don't know. Is that a phrase?
It's not. But I was gonna let you roll.
But let's go with that.
It's not hot until you put salsa on it. I don't think a chip.
Unless you got like Takis or something. I don't know.
True.
Either way, that comes with being like a college kid who like thinks that you know everything and like thinks that you're the
bee's knees.
That's a phrase. That's one. Yeah, okay. We can use that knees. One.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Good job.
That's what I'm here for.
But yeah, it's interesting to as a hater to the core myself, mm-hmm. to receive some negative energy from other people sometimes.
Yeah,
but
that's good. I'm glad that you're like. I think the biggest part of that is acknowledging it. Because if you don't acknowledge it, then, I mean, I think you'll always be in that position of where people think you're just like, oh, F him.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was a dick in college, mm-hmm. and we can own up to that. And as, I don't know if this still floats around upstairs, don't be a dick.
Kind of.
Yeah, well, it should, if there's anybody that should have learned from it, it was me. So.
Speaking of some of your time here, I want to share this fun clip of...
I've been warned about this.
Yeah, so there's a clip, and I know people on TV say, oh, he doesn't know. He really does not know of something interesting that happened during your time here. I don't want to say exactly what it is. We'll just watch it. And I want you to explain what's going on. Do we have the clip?
We need the small token.
Al, this is the small token.
Thank you very much.
Oh, what's happening here?
What was that? We needed the microphone.
Oh.
What?
Oh my God!
What?
On television?
What's
going on? On television? What happened?
I don't know.
You were so. This was. Yeah. Tell what was this?
This was the end of Brave-a-thon. Mm-hmm. And we normally do like a group goodbye, very similar to that of like SNL. Mm-hmm. A little goodbye shot and thank yous. I feel like you shouldn't be asking me for an explanation. Somebody ask Al what he was.
I think he went to either you did a very great job that day producing, or you know, he was trying to speak into your microphone. He didn't have a microphone on. I'm a little jealous. Al never tries to speak into my microphone. But
see,
we'll
I'm not a TV girl, so when somebody approaches my neck like that, I'm not thinking that there's a microphone here. Mm-hmm. So
you're like, want some? Yeah.